Hey everybody, Adam Savage here, surrounded by some of MythBusters history, and it's for an excellent reason. The props behind me and in front of me traveled around the United States as part of MythBusters, the explosive exhibition for the last 10 years. And that exhibit is over, but don't be sad because now the props from that show can go straight to your home. They're being auctioned off by Prop Store to benefit the Grant Imahara Steam Foundation. And you can own your very own piece of MythBusters history. And I'm doing show and tells about the pieces. And today I want to talk about golf ball car. Over the 13 years we made MythBusters, Jamie, Carrie, Grant, Tori, and I, we loved to talk about the fact of how seat of the pants it was, how much we were sort of blank slates when we began. We didn't really realize we were making a science show at the beginning. We kind of fell into it and figured it out. And there are a lot of methodologies and experiments that we conducted that are exceedingly primitive. This one, golf ball car, this is a maquette from the episode Golf Ball Car. This represents the other end of the spectrum of MythBusters scientific excursions, because I think of this as a myth that Jamie and I did when we felt quite mature about our ability to design and execute a reasonable scientific methodology. So the myth was a golf ball, before I tell you the myth, I have to give you one fact, which is that a golf ball has those detents, 544 of them? I can't quite remember, but a golf ball has little detents on it because they create a little bit of turbulent air that creates a slipstream around the golf ball that allows it to fly farther. I know that sounds weird, but if you shot a smooth golf ball that was the same weight as a dimpled golf ball, the dimpled golf ball flies far further. So we know this is an effect. We know that it works for a golf ball. The myth is that it could work for a car. And there are products out there that like cover your car with a wrap with little detents that are supposed to be able to do this effect. Jamie and I wanted to find out if you could do it for real. So this is where we began. We eventually covered an actual full-size car in several hundred pounds of wet clay and then carved 1,100 detents in its surface using a bunch of automotive prototypers from the Academy of Art College's automotive department. Yeah, like this was a sophisticated attempt at solving this myth, but this was our first prototype for testing it. And what we did was, we simply bought a vacuform shell for our remote control car, filled it with resin, and then drilled these hemispherical holes all the way around it. And we took this down to the NASA Ames Wind Tunnel facility, which is one of my favorite places on Earth. And we put this in their water tank, which is one of my favorite machines on Earth, honestly. The water tank is this reciprocating pool of perfectly laminar flowing water that moves past whatever object you put into it. The first time we put a car in there, the windows were down, and I started to notice this in the water tank, which uses fluorescing ink. I noticed this ink pattern coming off the car that we were using because the windows were down. It was like doing this. And I said, is that little turbulent thing, is that the reason I hear the pop, 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 pop when one of the windows of my car is open? And they were like, yes. And we were like, really? And they were like, yeah, that's called a strudel wave because it looks like a strudel. The water tank is just a place of wonder. Anyway, we put this car in our water tank and we witnessed what seemed to be the effect that we were looking for, which is that these detents did seem to, each in and of themselves, create a little bit of a turbulence that created a slipstream over the car. So the next step was to do this in a real car. And as I said, we brought a bunch of automotive sculptors from the Academy of Art. We carved this in the car. We ran it through our fuel efficiency tests, which, by the way, if you want to know precisely how much fuel you use in 1 mile to do a thing, it is really difficult to do. And we did it so many times and it was always an ass kicker. And I consider this to be our finest execution of that experiment, which is we took a car with no gasoline in it and put a 1 gallon tank. Then we weighed that tank both before and after the experiment to know exactly how much gas we had used. And when we finished running both tests with the unmodified car and the golf ball car, we got, I think, a 14% improvement in fuel efficiency for the golf ball car. This is one of those cases where in the episode, you see Jamie and I open the trunk, we take it out, we weigh it, we check our results, we laugh, we're surprised, we check the results again, we realize it's right, we call it a day, we shake hands, we leave. We were like, there's no coverage that you could shoot of that interaction with us that does, that's going to equate or be better than what we just got. So we didn't shoot any coverage. We literally just ended the episode with that because we were so surprised. There is one more story to go with golf ball car. And that is about a year later, we got an email from someone who worked with one of the big three automakers that they were curious about this. And what you might not know is that big car prototypes are actually made out of clay. Yeah, that's one of the key ways in which they prototype car forms. So they pulled this clay SUV frame they had out of storage, and some poor guy carved 1,000 detents in the outside of this clay car, and this automaker put it in their wind tunnel. And then they wrote us to say that they did not come to the same results we did. And that didn't bother me at all. One, they were using a totally different kind of car, so I don't consider that it's valid. It's apples and oranges, not really a scientific methodological approach that I would approve. But secondly, we wasted the time of a big three automaker for like a week. That is so cool. That's one of those ways in which MythBusters allowed all of us to feel kind of like peers with all the scientists we were working with. Like, we're asking genuinely interesting questions, and we're really trying to come up with robust ways to test them. Anyway, thanks for this walk down memory lane. Get yourself your own piece of MythBusters memorabilia. The address is propstore.com/MythBusters. This is all to benefit the Grant Imahara Steam Foundation, the most excellent of causes. And thank you guys. I'll see you next time.